The restaurant was lovely but dark. Only one small candle flickered on every table. Tucker ate light. Diners used their smartphones to read their menus, looked to their table mates, and even to see what they were eating. Finally, a patron quietly pushed back his chair, walked over to a waiter and asked a simple question. "Could you turn on the lights?" Before long, a warm ceiling light flashed on and the room erupted with applause, but also with laughter and happy chatter and thank yous. My friend's husband turned off his phone, picked up his utensils, and spoke for us all. "Let there be light. Now let's eat." Our gloomy evening turned festive with the flick of a switch. But how much more important to know the real source of true light. God himself spoke to those astonishing words, "Let there be light," on the first day when he created the universe, and there was light. Genesis 1 verse 3. Then God saw that the light was good, verse 4. Light expresses God's great love for us. His light points us to Jesus, the light of the world, John 8 verse 12, who guides us from the gloom of sin. Walking in his light, we find the bright path to a life that glorifies the sun. He is the world's brightest gift. As he shines, may we walk his way. Heavenly Father, we thank you for Jesus, the light of the world, and the guiding light of his great love. Lord, I know my relationship with you is the key to having peace and a great purpose in my life. Please help me to put you first and love you with all my heart. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.